Hello friends, welcome back. In this session, I'll show you clearly how to install Keras. Also, I'll show you the power of Keras as in what are the options available with Keras. We can go step by step, and the first step is to make sure that you open the Anaconda prompt properly. I have done that right now in my Windows 10 machine. Wherever you have installed it, make sure that you launch and run all these commands in the Anaconda prompt. Let me open it right now. You may require appropriate permission for launching it. So if you need so, please run it as an administrator. But sometimes you can run it directly if you have permissions available by default. Now you need to go to the path where you have the notebook available with you. I mean the code available with you. Installation can be done from anywhere. Since it would be easier for me to go to the appropriate path where I have got notebook, I am navigating to that path. But otherwise it's easy. Pip install Keras is the command that I need to issue, and you can see that right on screen. If it is not already installed, you will get the installation done in few seconds and you will get a message as successfully installed Keras. So once the installation is all done, you can open the Jupyter Notebook from the path where you've got the files available for you to be accessed. I'm going to open a file where I have imported, I have used Keras, and I have issued Jupyter Notebook from the path I can easily access it. Now you can see that I'm going to search the file here, which I have already kept over there, and the file name is simple MNIST using Keras. So I have opened it. Now you can see that this is a very simple thing where I have imported NumPy first, and then this is running on top of TensorFlow, so I have imported Keras from TensorFlow. Similarly, I need layers. Whenever you are talking about deep learning and machine learning, it's all about layers. So I have got layers over there from TensorFlow.Keras. I have imported it. If it is all successful, you can run it and see that. Now I'm going to show you how successful it is. Yes, it's successful. The next thing is, you have a lot of data sets available over there in Keras, and I have accessed it easily, and I have shown you that right now. Let's see that part as well right now once again. You can see that here I have got the datasets.mnist, so I can use the keras.datasets and I can pull out whatever dataset I can want through this option. And the most important point that I would like to stress here is you have got multiple datasets available inside and you can pull out whichever one you want. Here I have used something called as mnist. And then you can see that here I have used sequential. It's all about sequential, step after another. So we are going to use sequential option that is also made available with Keras. And I have used all these in the code, and this is all completely done with Keras. The point is, the Keras helps you in getting the data set. The Keras helps you in building the model sequentially, where you can have the convolution layer, max pooling layer, flatten layer, dropout layer. The sequence can also be built with the support of the options available in Keras. And when I run it, it will all be successful if your installation is proper. The whole point here is, if you have installed proper, things will run proper, and you can see that in front of you. The installation can be done with pip install Keras. Uninstallation can also be done with pip uninstall command. That can be used as well. Pip uninstall Keras will uninstall that, but make sure that you do it in the right path. That's it. I hope you like the content. If you have any questions, please go ahead and type it in the comment section. I'll be able to answer them. Thank you.